Shazam is the latest DC movie to be released, starring Zachary Levi as the titular hero, Shazam! I had to. Shazam follows the story of Billy Batson as he tries to find his mother while being pushed around into a new environment that he doesn't want to be in. Then he gets the powers of the wizard Shazam, and he has to fight evil. Honestly, one of the best things about this movie, for me at least, is the fact that this is a child, and the character acts like a kid throughout the entire movie. When he first gets these powers, he uses them to show off and to try and make money. One of the first things he does with these powers is buy beer. He turns into an adult and buys booze. That is hilarious. The way that he acts like a child who has suddenly been put into a body of an adult and can do pretty much whatever he wants. Because that's what he is. It's very funny. There's also a very touching message in this movie about the power of family. Throughout most of the film, he's trying to find his mother, who he lost when he was about 3 years old. Spoiler alert, he does manage to find her. That's kind of par for the course for a story like this. Throughout the rest of the film, he is with this foster family that he doesn't want to be with, but they're being there for him. The father and mother are constantly trying to make him feel like he's welcome, and the rest of the kids are doing their best to make that feeling, to make him feel that way as well. And he, by the end of it, comes to realize that he needs them as a family, and he can't just be on his own. It's a very powerful message that people kind of need to hear. Your family's your family. You don't really get another chance with them. Even if you don't get along with them the best, they're still all you have. Anyway, back to the actual fun part. The villain, Mark Strong, is one of the best villains ever. He is hilarious. I love him. I really want him to be the villain in every movie that has ever been made. It is so funny. His accent is a little weird. Like, he tried to take his Scottish accent and make it American, but he's not good at the American accent, so it's like a hybrid of the two. It's not awful, and like, for a Scottish American, it actually would probably sound fine. It's just really, really weird to hear that, at least for me, initially. By the end of the movie, it's normal and you kind of just get used to it. You know, the seven deadly sins are what give him his power, and they're really funny. Just the way that they act. He is probably the perfect villain for Shazam. Because he's pretty much the antithesis. He's had his family his entire life, but he hates them. They're kind of assholes and he doesn't get along with them. So it's the fact he's pretty much the exact opposite of Billy, or Shazam, if you want to call him that, in this film. It's a nice opposite villain as opposed to what Black Adam is, where Black Adam is basically just Shazam, but over 5,000 years old from ancient Egypt, with the same powers. Personally, I've never actually liked Black Adam as a character, but that's gonna get onto a tangent. I'll make this video about 5 hours long. It's a very, very solid outing for the DC franchise, and honestly, DC has finally picked up their stride with their two great movies in a row that I have very much enjoyed, Aquaman and then this. I hope that they keep going. I hope they make a fun, enjoyable universe, because I really do like the DC characters. That's pretty much all that I have to say. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe to my channel. Comment on this video, tell me if you enjoyed it, what I can do to improve those videos in the future, and that's gonna be all for this video. Anyway guys, I hope that you enjoyed this review, and as always, peace out.